Monday, and then to Ankara on Tuesday, and Izmir on Wednesday. And the purpose of the visit is to emphasise the UK's commitment to partnering with Turkey in the development of bilateral trade and investment by UK businesses in Turkey, and to encourage investment by Turkish businesses and investors in the UK. We are focusing on particular sectors, financial services, and the Istanbul Financial Centre is one which London, with its great expertise and experience in financial services, is keen to help with its development. So financial services is one sector. I am a lawyer by professional background. London is a major global centre for legal services and dispute resolution. And we will be having a couple of sessions about dispute resolution, not simply advertising London's expertise, but developing links between Turkish lawyers and UK lawyers about methods of resolving disputes under the heading of unlocking disputes. We have in London a new commercial court in a building known as Rowland's Building, which brings together the largest concentration of judicial expertise in commercial matters in the world, and that is something that we want Turkish businesses and Turkish lawyers to be aware of. But that part of the visit is not simply a one-way process of promoting, if you like, a British product. It's partly about that, but also developing links between British lawyers and Turkish lawyers, for which purpose I'm delighted to be meeting with the President of the Istanbul Bar Association on Monday morning. Investment into Turkey is making more investment outside Turkey. The UK and lawyers based in the UK are the most global. We have several of the biggest global law firms are based in and originate in the UK, so we have most experience in dealing with international commercial and legal matters. So that's the second theme of the visit. The third theme is investment in infrastructure through public-private partnerships, on which we're holding an event in Izmir on Wednesday. The UK has a vast amount of experience of bringing together public and private sector funds. For the UK in November, the two principal formal events of which were a banquet at Buckingham Palace in honour of the President, given by Her Majesty the Queen on Tuesday evening, and on the following evening, on Wednesday, I think it was the 24th of November, I think it was, a dinner in honour of the President, hosted by me in Guildhall. I had the pleasure of sitting between President Gould and Mrs. Gould for an evening, and they were both very good company. And during that visit, I met Deputy Prime Minister Mr. Bojan, and I'll be seeing him also on Tuesday afternoon, and the Minister of Economy. In those meetings, I will be stressing the enthusiasm that Britain has for its relationship with Turkey, for developing trade and cultural links and educational links, and our continued support for Turkey's bid to join the European Union. We are each at different ends of the European continent, and there's a certain amount of geographical symmetry, and there's a certain amount of philosophical and psychological symmetry as well. Visa policy, because that question comes up everywhere. In a way, I think John might be right to say, in a way it's our own fault from the point you made that Britain isn't the relaxed end in relation to Turkey, and in even recent years, in comparison with other countries, we have been very relaxed in immigration policy and very easy. And when the government, this country is really instructed by the electorate to change policy, because we've created an expectation that it would be easy, when that changes, people in other countries feel more aggrieved than they do about countries into which they had no expectation of being able to get in at all, because it's always been hard and it continues to be hard. That's the point. That's what I mean about saying it's our own fault. Because
yes.
We've created one expectation and then we're rowing back from it. There has been some element of complaint about the process in the way in which applications have been handled, and the UK Borders Agency. These matters are handled by the Home Office rather than the Foreign Office, and the Home Office does it, manages the process through the UK Borders Agency. And the Borders Agency has been making a major effort to improve the process. There were a lot of stories in the early days about visa applications being refused for what were apparently technical, you hadn't filled the form in correctly, and it was taking too long. But a lot of progress has been made in those regards. And you still hear complaints. A gentleman from Russia a few weeks ago complained that if he wanted to get to France, the form was 2 pages. If you want to go to Germany, the form was 3 pages. To come into the UK was 27 pages. Now, I don't know.
Yeah.
And it's right. We are constantly encouraging government to the Borders Agency to be as quick and as practical as they can. And I think they're moving in that direction. We will continue to encourage them in that direction. We're also encouraging them to distinguish more between those who wish to come here for business reasons, because having here able business-minded people from Turkey is exactly what we want to have our economy moving in the right direction. Therefore, obstacles to people who are going to be economically productive should be reduced. And the government's trying to move in that direction, though it's not easy, because politically the government has also got targets to get population down. So I'm sorry to give you such a long answer, but yes, I do expect comment, and I shall give an answer along the lines that I've just given. My answer was so long that I'm afraid I've forgotten what your second question was.
London 2012.
Yes. London is looking forward, been looking forward to a wonderful Olympic Games, which we say with our self-deprecatory English humour is unusual in that we are going to deliver a major project ahead of time and below budget, which we think is quite rare for us in our English humour. So we think it's going to be, we also think that we have built up a great deal of expertise in how to create, produce and manage a project like the Olympic Games, which experience we're very happy to share with Istanbul in its bid for 2020, which is over the long term. The shorter term, we're keen for as many countries as possible to share in the experience of the 2012 Olympic Games, and we hope a lot of people from Turkey, particularly business people, will come here in between July and September and enjoy the world's largest festival.